tonight. We give God thanks, we give God praise, we give him glory, and we give him honor. Because he is good and there is nobody like our God. Hallelujah. We bless your name, God. We bless your name, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, we give you glory.
Give God the praise, the glory, and the honor that is due. to his name. Here's our worship, all of our worship. Father, receive my worship.
with me during a rough time of my life. And so as I say it, if that is your situation right now, you can't understand. You've been doing all that you can. You've been serving God all your life. Yet still, you're going through. But let me tell you something. From the time that song was given to me until now, I can see why I have been through what I've gone through. Because there's a growth and a maturity that happens. There's a stretching that happens when you go through situations that nobody else can help you with. The only thing that you can do is turn your face towards heaven, is turn to God. And He's a God who never changes. He will never leave you nor forsake you. He will never say, I had enough of you. He's a good, good Father. He's a good, good Shepherd. He's a good, good Baba. He's a good God. And so as I sing this song, if you're going through, reach out and believe God. Worship God with me.
Without hope.
family, immediate family, extended family, church family gatherings. We thank you for them, Lord. We thank you for ministering to them through me. I'm just a vessel to be used by you. So all the glory, whatever has happened, whatever has transpired in the spirit, Lord God, we say, let your kingdom come, let your will be done on earth, in earth, as it is in heaven. We thank you for a manifestation of your spirit in our midst, as we come to worship you tomorrow, or even those who may be worshiping today, worshiping in their homes, worshiping at a gathering. We thank you that you will come and manifest yourself with miracles, signs, and wonders. We pray for worship leaders and worshipers, those who are called, the Levites that are called to lead your people to the most holy place, Father God. We thank you for the veil that has been rent, so that we don't have to wait on some high priest to do what you have, Lord God, ordained for us to do in this time. As kings and priests, Lord God, we can go into the most holy place. We can connect with you, Lord, where everything that pertains to life and godliness exists. So we thank you for blessing us even right now. Blessing the worship leaders. Give them an unction from on high. Cause them, Lord, when they stand, Father God, to stand as an oracle, Lord God, of you. Give them the words to say. Let there be a fire in their bellies, Father God. So that they're not just a vessel, but they're a vessel filled by you as a conduit, Lord, to those persons that they are ministering to. We thank you, Lord God, for Reverend Clarice and her family. We thank you for Bishop and Taylor, his family, and the church at Sheffield. We thank you, Lord God, we see a harvest of souls coming, Father God, in these end times, because we know that the field is ripe and it's ready for picking. It's ripe for picking. So we ask you for laborers that will come and join with us. Lord God, we are not thinking about denomination. We are not thinking about political affiliation. We are not thinking about anything. We are thinking about your kingdom, because your kingdom supersedes every other organization that we might have here in this earth. And so, Father God, we see your kingdom coming as we walk in this vineyard, wherever we are, to see souls coming. Lord, we thank you for provision, because we can't do it without the currency of the day. We thank you for provision, so that we can go into all the world and preach the gospel. Even you, Lord God, said, give unto Caesar what belongs to Caesar. So we need to be able to pay our bills. We need to be able to pay our rent. We need to pay for transport. We need to pay for air transport. We just need money, God, because money answers all things. God, our hearts against loving it more than we love you. But we need money to do what you've called us to do, because that's why people are separate from us right now. Thank you for provision, supernatural provision in this season. We give you all praise. We thank you for Damion and Omarie. Bless them beyond measure, Lord God, for the sacrifice that they made today to be here, to usher in your presence. Bless them, Lord. They have needs. They have desires as young men. Bless them, Lord God, beyond their wildest dreams. As somebody said, blow their minds this year. Blow their minds with what you want to do in their lives. Just because they decided to come and support Minister ssuueebest and Reverend Clarice and the others in what we are doing. We bless you today. We give you all the glory and the honor for what you've done and for what you will continue to do. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. The Lord bless you.
blessings and wealth you have surpassed my expectation, and we are truly blessed over here in the United Kingdom with your ministry. One person asked me, did you record it? I said, no, we didn't plan to record. But guess what? There's a reason why it wasn't recorded. There's a reason why.
Okay.
Because we are going to have ssuueebest here in the United Kingdom.
Wow.
I have caught things which are not as though they were. So if you are totally tremendously blessed, which I know you are, and you want to help me make this happen, my bishop is marrying me. If you want to help me make this happen, that she come over here, and I'm telling you, worship saves. Worship saves. And if you want to make this happen, when we would have her life, I believe this is God's appointed time. Susan, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. And I'm going to ask Sister Akina to just pray a blessing over you, Omarie and Damion, for really just giving your all for the glory of God.